teisaki with the blue futon. Out of the box, or out of the wall, wherever you want to do it, we have Frailty. Bill Paxton directed with Matthew McConaughey. All right. Have I seen this one? Yes. I don't remember that much of it, but let's go rewatch and I'll let you know if it's worth your time, because Two Thumbs Way Up, one of the best films, entertainment by Stephen King. Stephen King is a weird mofo. Oh, wrong way. There we go. So Frailty, what's it about? Well, it's about a family with a dad and the two boys. Unfortunately, the wife passed away, giving birth to the youngest one. And this one is a kind of a timeline story of Matthew McConaughey saying, "I know who a killer is," to an FBI agent. "But before I give you all the story, I need you to tell my past." And this past story is with Bill Paxton, with the kids basically saying Bill Paxton had a vision from God saying, "I'm going to give you a list of demons. I'm going to give you weapons, and you need to do my work for me and kill these demons." And so Bill Paxton's waiting for these signs, waiting for these weapons that God's going to give him. Axe, gloves, and a pipe. And with this, what he has to do is go to these people, touch the people, and visions will show up if they're actually demons or not. But the problem is, one of the kids believes the dad, and one of the kids does not. Which one is Matthew McConaughey? Let's find out at the end. So this movie is absolute perfection. Completely agree with Two Thumbs Way Up, best films of the year. This came out in 2002. Fantastic movie. Holy cow. Even though it's rated R for violence in some language, it's actually a very tame R-rated movie. Not a lot of gore, not a lot of, you know, language at all. Of course, the only violence is you see them swinging the axe of killing these people. Maybe they're people, maybe they're demons. That's the whole point of the story, is he actually doing God's work? Or is he just killing these people and he's going insane in the membrane? This movie is filled with a lot of twists and turns of who is who, what's actually happening, and believability. But this movie is just crisp. Crisp directing. Crisp acting. Crisp writing. This movie is done so well that it is so low budgetly well perfect. This is a perfect example of a low budget movie in my opinion. You have Matthew McConaughey, you know, back in 2002, Bill Paxton, and Power Booth as well as the FBI agent. But man, when the actual last 20 minutes occurs in this movie, it is the most perfect bow on a gift a movie can give you. I understand completely. I know Bill Paxton only directed, I want to say, two movies that came to theaters, this one and The Greatest Game Ever Played. I completely understand why you would want to take this one on, because the end 20 minutes is just so pitch perfect gold. Like I said, there's nothing more perfect than a movie. It takes you on a story, and the story is entertaining, fascinating, and you don't know what to believe. But those last 20 minutes put a bow on it where it just says, and that is this movie. That's all I'm going to say about this movie, because there's way too many spoilers in this movie. I do not want you to spoil this movie at all. I think this is how a movie... This reminded me, actually, that was a weird burp. This reminded me of Identity of some sorts. But like you said, I'm not the biggest fan of Identity. Maybe I need to rewatch it and do like a rewatch, because a lot of people hate that video. That was like one of my first five videos I ever did too on this channel. And it went through the roof in a bad way, apparently. But Frailty, gift, bow, perfection. Frailty will receive a 5 out of 5 Blue Futon. I think it was at 100%. So see the critics' new scores gave this film. You have critics, a 74% of the 152 of them. Audience score, 78 with 53-66. Here's critic consensus. Creepy and disturbing. Frailty is well-crafted, low-key horror. I am curious on the budget. It doesn't really say. It just says it made $13 million in the box office. But I can see some people not liking it because of the religious aspect of it, of God telling Bill Paxton's character, "We need you to kill these demons." And then you have the whole atheist versus faith people going at this movie. One side's going to like it a lot more than the other. That's all I'm going to say. But do you agree with my 100%? The 74, the 78. I can't find nothing wrong with this movie. I can't. Like, acting great. Directing great. Story great. Suspense great. Like, it's a bow. It's a bow. So, please like the Blue Food Town. Like, comment, subscribe. One of the things is Blue Town Topia. Blue Food Town. Just thanks for watching. Have a great day. And let's keep this going and have a great life.